Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Astrological Intentions. This is a very special astrological interview. I am your host, Alex Reavy, along with Sandy Reavy, my mother.
Hi, Alex. Yeah, I'm here.
So we have on air with us today is Doug Upchurch of Brave, Real, Loving Human Radio. I know that's a long message, but you will understand by the end of this episode just what that means. So a little bit of background here. Doug Upchurch is a learning and development executive, leadership coach. He's spent 29 years developing relevant and accessible learning experiences for leaders, teams, organizations all around the world. He is the host of the podcast Brave, Real, Loving Human Radio, focused on helping us all be a little more brave, real, loving, and human in our lives. Doug is also the founder and principal of Practical Soul, his intuitive coaching practice. As a coach and intuitive, he is passionate about helping others get reconnected to themselves, their natural gifts, and their soul's purpose.
He is a soul minister.
He really, truly is. And I want to give you guys a quick update here. This is so exciting for us because Doug has been in the queue for this for a while. So we, without further ado, welcome you to this very special astrological interview.
You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys.
Welcome on to the show, Doug.
Hi, you guys. It's so good to be here.
It is.
I'm so excited.
I know. I want to like give you a little like, I don't know, take your cheeks and go and like hug you all the way from Chicago to Portland.
Yes.
Yeah. I love it. You know, I'm sending it right back to both of you. I love you both so much. And I'm so excited to do this with you guys tonight.
Good. You know, we've been doing this podcast for about a year and a half now. And I know that, you know, I started listening to your podcast, man, early on, earlier this year. So we're going to talk a little bit about that and how that's taken us on a journey.
Yes. And so I want to quick make the connection for the listeners. Doug, how did you and Sandy first meet? Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah. So I work very closely with intuitive and author Colette Baron-Reed, who has a program called The Oracle School. I'm her head wizard of learning and development. And Sandy came out and did some work for some mastermind groups we were doing, and I got a chance to be in a workshop with Sandy and just was completely blown away and immediately, you know, hired Sandy to do some personal malas for myself as I was going through a pretty big transition, leading a career of 20 years in corporate and executive learning and development, and starting my own kind of venture, of which the podcast and the radio show is a part of that. But it became really clear that the work that Sandy and you do, Alex, that what you brought to the table for me is work that would help guide and almost provide an anchor for me as I was going through these big transitions in my life. So I was in the right place at the right time and really grateful that Sandy's in my path crossed. I guess it was fall of 2018.
It was. And one of the things that we immediately connected around was our Leo risings.
Yeah.
Right. Your 15 degree Leo rising, my 20 Leo rising. It was like, I see you, I recognize you, and I love your blue hair and your blue glasses and your blue shirt and your blue mala now. But I recognize that place of leadership you hold. It's very apparent. Mm. And I think you saw it back and we were just like, buddies immediately, right? With total respect. So
without question.
Yeah. And I know Alex is the hostess here. I always want to take all these and go my route. Meanwhile, Alex is like, Mom, I'm sitting right
I'm
here.
I'm reeling her back in. Yes, of course. So I wanna first mention and say that Brave, Real, Loving Human Radio is really cool and very inspiring. I was listening to your last episode. It was the living conversation of having a body. And can you give us a little bit of a what really inspired this? What was this discussion about?
Yeah, I might have to just do a little bit of context if that's all right.
Oh, of course.
Alex, because, you know, one of the things I knew when I left my career of 20 years that part of what I wanted to do was create a movement. And the movement of the question, what would it be like if we all asked ourselves, how can we be a little more brave, real, loving, and human in our lives and in our world? You know, at different points in our lives, we'll face what I call an archetypal calling, a time that shows up that says, I need to step out of my comfort zone. I need to be more brave, whatever it is that we face, or I need to be more real with someone that I'm in a close, intimate relationship with, or more loving with my family or my community of choice. Or maybe just be more human with the people I share this planet with. Mm. And these callings really started to speak to me. And so I wanted to start a radio show where I could talk to people about what did those four words mean to them, that they could share their story. Mm. And in May of this year, I launched the podcast, a radio show with the first episode, which really was me an interview with myself to talk about being brave. Mm. Now, what's really interesting about that is that was on a Monday. On a Tuesday, I found out that I had stage 4 lung cancer and began a healing journey that I had no idea was going to show up in my life. And so it was almost like, let's talk about being brave. And then the universe kind of said, hold my beer. let's see how really you're going to be able to handle being brave. And I will tell you, those four words have become something very different. So my podcast has two parts to it. There are interviews with still these amazing people that I have come to know in my life that talk about how those four callings resonate with them. And equally, I needed to have a place where I could share what was going on for me. And so I created a few episodes that are called A Living Conversation. These are my own story that I kind of write down about what has it been like to live in this healing journey that I've been on. And Sandy's been a part, you, of course, as you know, have been a part of that from the beginning with a mala for my healing journey that has been very special to me. But this particular episode you're talking about, Alex, you know, having a body, it's really confronting when your body starts to do what I would say almost felt like betray you. It's like, why is this happening to me? Mm. Why did this occur? And, you know, I've had a great life. I've had a really wonderful career, and I've made a lot of difference in the world. And I'm not afraid to die, But I had to realize something that was pretty profound and hard, that actually the brave thing is to live.
Yes.
The brave thing is to say, I want to stick around. And what is it that I'm here for, that I have to have a body for? And so the idea of, you know, having a body is about why, what are the things that I want to do with my life? You might call them bucket lists. You might call them, you know, to-do lists.
Yeah,
it could be as simple as saying, I'm going to take an Epsom salt bath on this day and soap, you know, soak myself in essential oils and just take care of my body. Or it might be, I want to go dancing with my partner, or I want to get out and walk around the block with the dogs. Things that when you have a limited breath capacity can be really challenging, as I do. So for me, it's been really about finding a way to both share the stories of other people and their journey with Brave Your Loving Human, but equally sharing it for me as well. And that particular episode, the most recent one, Having a Body, was about how do I do that? That was really about me being brave to say, no, I'm sticking around, and really to be loving to the people that are in my life that love me, that want me to be here. And I'm clear I'm not done yet. So that, thanks for asking about that.
Well, I love this name of the podcast, because it's something that does not roll off your tongue, or I should say my tongue, but it's really a concentrated thought process to get these words correct, because they're dynamite words, right? It's like brave. Okay, what would the next one be? Real, right? Next one, loving. Next one, human. Because it's not a four words that have been put together in a, you know, in a brand or a title until now, right? Yeah. So it encompasses it so much. But when you say it, every time that Alex and I have said it, it's, we have to think about it, right? Mm-hmm. It's slower to come out of our mouths, which then makes us think about that and pause. So I love what you've titled it. Yeah. And then living conversation, you know, it's what people are listening to. It's how they're engaging with you.
Yeah. And it was beautifully written. I mean, the way your expression of this whole entire process is a true testament of really who you are. And really, while you were just discussing, you know, with us about what this kind of, like, I guess, inspiration or this kind of culprit would be that made you talk about this, it reminded me of the idea that you don't really know your true character until you've had to really step up and get there.
Absolutely. One of the things that I said in the very early stages of this journey is I had no idea how strong I was until I had to use it for myself. I was really good at being a coach and a guide for other people in my life, whether it was professionally or personally. But this is the biggest thing I've ever had to face or deal with. And what I am, and I still sometimes will look in the mirror or have a conversation with somebody and be like, I don't really know exactly how I'm navigating all of this, but the things that I do know is that transparency is helpful for me. Authenticity is helpful for me. Being brave. Like, I can't change my diagnosis. What I can do is I can, you know, consult with the best medical teams, the best healing teams, the best support resources I have, and do that. So that's what I do, which is being brave there. But then I've got to be real. I've got to be open and authentic. And of course, you know, my parents are still with me and still on this planet, my partner and the people that love me. So the whole world of loving in that space, it's a very different, it means something very different when you're faced with your mortality in the way that I have been this year. And of course, immediately the human side is, if I talk to anybody else, whether I know them or not, if I know they've gone through the same diagnosis I have, I immediately have a connection to them and a sense of our shared humanity. So it is it's been such a challenge to both identify and recognize who I'm becoming in this process. And I'm not there yet. Like, I'm still learning more about that, about who I am and what's kind of happening. In fact, I think what's really interesting to me is what really was Brave, Real, Loving Human supposed to be? if I knew that this diagnosis was going to happen, like how would I have planned it differently? And so things like workshops or books, all those are things I'm thinking about.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's really an incredible, you know, undertaking that you kind of like you were creating, and then all of a sudden it is now evolving into such a bigger and more poignant, you know, message that you're sending to the world, you know. And recently we just had a friend of ours kind of like tragically pass away from being hit by a car. And what, you know, we all don't realize is that we are faced with these like mortality things on a daily basis, but it is a different diagnosis, you know, when that happens and that news is given to you, the way that you had been, you know, informed about it. You know, I think that right now you're an incredible inspiration, and it is most important for you to stay that inspiring person just for yourself too.
Right.
And I think I'm proud of you for that.
I'm proud of you and love you. And I want to switch up a little bit because you know, of course I'm on your Facebook page. I read your dailies or every other day, but I particularly have an add on to a story you put on. You went to see a concert and I'm going to tell you something else. Well, not what I told you over the phone the other day, but the opener. The guitar player, right, Niall?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
I did not.
So give a little context to the listeners because they're not sure what you're talking about.
Well, Doug, go ahead. Tell them you were at the concert. So,
I love live music, and I will.
I'll tell you
another little secret that BRL, Brave Real Loving, are actually the initials for a drag persona I birthed for my 50th birthday named Big Roxy Love. So I just gotta say that, right? So Big Roxy Love, or Be Real, BRL,
right?
She's all about being the biggest, brashiest part of herself. And I had the opportunity to see Cher, and that is just such a Big Roxy Love thing. Like, I got to go see her. I love live concerts. And Nile Rodgers and Chic, the band, the disco band. And most people don't know Nile Rodgers' names, but if they know his music, he's written songs by all kinds of people. So, I was there. Yes. Amazing experience the other night. Frankly, too, by the way, the day after I got news that my chemotherapy, which I had two rounds of, was not working. This is my second treatment option that the cancer in my body has been resistant to for whatever reason. So it was in kind of an interesting spot. And here I am now at this amazing concert with Cher and Nile Rodgers. So here's a little context.
Well, so here is this part of the story. And you share this about Nile getting on the microphone and making this big statement about his beautiful recovery, remission of lung cancer, correct?
Wow.
Two different aggressive cancers. I don't even know what kind.
Oh.
I haven't done the research, but he's two aggressive cancers is what they were. You may know more than me.
Well, no, because here's the deal. About 10 years ago, I helped with this big project called The Oneness in Los Angeles. And I would buy a table and I would show up and I sometimes wouldn't have a full table of guests that I would bring. And one night, my friend who organizes it, he said, you know, I know you don't have a date, but I'm going to, I've assigned you a date for, he'll be with you at your table. I'm no problem. And here comes Nile Rodgers was my date that night.
Oh my gosh.
So he ended up getting an award that night for the Oneness project. But anyway, he was my dinner partner. Anyway, I just had to
And
tell
then
you that.
Also, Cher was the headliner for this.
Yeah.
Yes.
And so you put the next morning, because you had videoed her her
singing
mantra.
A mantra. I thought that was so interesting.
The Gayatri mantra,
The Gayatri mantra.
Yeah.
And when I listened to it the next morning, it was like I told you, I'm like, you turned me on. I now listen to that every morning through Cher, and I cannot find it. Like, she's recorded that anywhere.
I don't think she has.
Right. Yeah. I have to go back to your video to watch it in the mornings when I get home.
You're the reason I'm getting all those hits on Facebook.
It was a very cool video.
And really, Doug, thank you for all that you do. All that you do that you don't even know you do. That's the point here. Wow.
Thank you. You're welcome.
I mean, you know, I'm looking at your chart here.
So let's move into the chart. Well, I'll give you the go ahead here.
Well, you know, I love the fact that we talk about mystic, we talk about soul minister. Because having that as goals and intentions, and you know, I'm looking at your chart here that has your Neptune. You have a Neptune conjunct Mercury, and this is your dream. This is your dreaming. You know, where your spiritual connections that you need to, you understand it easily. It's that mystic. You understand Mercury is the planet of communication. Neptune is the planet of healing, compassion. It also recognizes creativity, imagination, and you have this in a conjunction. So it really, and it's in one of the planets here, Mercury is in Sagittarius, which is getting hit today and over the last 4 days by the sun, because you know the sun just moved into Sagittarius.
Yes.
So you're, yes, there is so. This there is this like shine sun, the brightness of Sagittarius, of your thinking to take it out of the small little details and take it big, and you know, through philosophy or your wisdom or using that Neptune of the magic, the mystical, that healer, that healing that you own. And we're watching that, you know, through this brave, real, loving human experience. So interesting right now, when we got on the call, the moon was sitting on your sun. So we know that you're Sagittarius.
Oh, wow.
And we just had the, we know if I'm dating this call or not, but we just had the new moon in Sagittarius earlier today. And so this moon is hitting your sun, which really does bring a inner harmony. So the fact that you could go, you know, you're planning to go somewhere tonight and to kind of escape and go into like a fantastical.
Yes.
Maybe. Yes. I want to make it bigger than that. We're both Leo risings. But I can see where, you know, your moon and your Mars are also conjunct in the sky, so that you do have an emotional fight, right? You have it within you to stand up and do what is needed, you know, to kind of protect yourself.
Yeah, it's been an interesting day. I had two very important medical appointments today as well, and felt like it was just perfectly timed actually with the new moon. And also the last few, if I'm not mistaken, the last few days of Jupiter and Sagittarius as well, the last period of time, right?
Yep, correct.
Like I wore my Jupiter and Sagittarius mala tonight for our call because it's so, for me, that's what I believe I'm now. All of this that has been happening in my life has been in service of that expansion of what's next. And you mentioned soul minister. I think to just give a little personal context to that, I grew up in a very conservative religious kind of environment of my own choosing, frankly. But because I was gay, I wasn't able to align that. And I had a call to be a minister, but I never could quite figure that out. And over the past year and a half, I knew that that was coming back. And this term soul minister is what's come up for me. Ooh. Where it's about helping people with the care and feeding of their soul.
Chills.
It's not about religion. It's not about anything other than meaning and purpose and grace and connection in their lives. And so it's so special to me. And so I'm kind of just, and to be very candid, getting this diagnosis has kind of given me a bit of a, I don't give a dang, you know, pardon the expression. I don't give it, you know what?
Yeah, right.
Because I'm just going to be me.
Yeah.
And so this is why I'm here. Yeah.
Yeah, especially with Jupiter hitting your Mercury and your Sun all year, you know, it has been really, it's given you, you know, sometimes Jupiter can give you too much, right? It's Jupiter does want growth, but sometimes it can give too much growth. But I think now that, you know, Jupiter is moving on and going into Sagittarius, or into leaving Sagittarius and going into Capricorn, where like growth will be a little bit slower, which is okay for us all, right?
Yeah.
You know, it's like, you know, to be a little bit more stable in our growth, a little bit more conservative. But you know, you have the, you have your natal sun in a really tight trine to your Leo rising. So, you know, you are the optimistic mover and groover and shaker and pulling people up that aren't as hopeful or optimistic as, you know, you reign, you know, you reign on that. So I love the fact that you're back at your podcast. You're doing some things for Q1 that you're going to roll out the beginning of the year. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, I'm really excited. We did, you know, I took a little bit of a break because of the fact that we were doing all this work on my healing journey. Mm-hmm. And but I have three episodes of the podcast, interviews that are in the can that we're going to be editing here and hopefully having out soon.
Okay.
With some amazing people, author of a book by the name of Deep Creativity, a friend that I know here in Portland who's at the age of, in his early 30s, started losing his hearing. Huh. And what was that like to do that and to experience that in a braver, loving human way? And some other folks as well that I'm excited to share with our listeners. But part of what I want to do is start this conversation. Like, it's not just about a show or a radio show. It's about, what does it mean for each of us when we are faced with an archetypal calling of some kind? And again, if you're not familiar with that phrase, I think it's helpful to say. In astrology, we understand the idea of archetypes because these are these universal symbols that have a personal relationship to us.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Well, an archetypal calling is a calling that everyone has to respond to at some point in their life. We don't get a choice, but it's personal. So brave is when you step out of your comfort zone, as I said earlier, and each of these come to us through any number of ways, that things that happen in our lives. And, you know, hopefully for many of you, it's not anything like what I've had to deal with this year, but that whole idea is, what would it look like then if, rather than being surprised by life as it happens, what if when we are faced with a calling, we lean into that? We know, where and how can I be more brave right now in my life? Where and how can I be more loving or more real? And so the goal is to begin to create some learning experiences, which is, again, based on my own professional background, where people can come together either in an online or a face-to-face capacity and start to really move into the flow of being with those callings as they show up in their lives. To serve the purpose, frankly, of finding meaning in our lives, finding a more authentic experience of living, an experience of grace, which for me is just accepting ourselves exactly as we are, and a sense of connectedness, a deep connectedness to ourselves, to others, to that which is bigger than ourselves, whatever that means for you. So I'm really excited about what's to come, definitely in terms of the podcast,
but
also the learning experiences. So stay tuned.
Sign me up. Yeah. Sign me up. That explanation right there is just so appealing. And it's a beautiful question that you ask of, where and how can I show up as brave right now? And I think that's a very powerful thing.
And I mean, you didn't come here to be a follower. You know, you came here to be a leader, and in this experience or any experience you have is doing exactly that. It's that big Roxy love leader.
Yeah.
Be real.
Yeah.
Yes. Be real human. That's why BRL, be real human.
Yeah.
Be real human is kind of the acronym that I love in that. But listen, I've not always been that way. I appreciate that acknowledgement, Sandy, and I know that there are people out there that may not feel that way. I know I didn't always feel that way, and I have to say that one of my challenges has been to finally just own my own sense of voice and to really lean into that. And I'm grateful for the teachers I've had, for the experiences I've had, and to some degree, this wisdom of mortality that I faced that's kind of brought the wisdom of dying into my living. Right? This idea of, how do I live differently? And And so, you know, no matter where everybody's at as they're listening, I hope that they will find what that looks like for them, because that would be my goal in any conversation I had with anybody right now, is what does it look like for you to do that?
Right. For us each to step into our individuality, you know, your moon in Aquarius, that's who you are to not fit into a, you know, into a round circle where, you know, you're, you know, different and unusual, unique, brilliant, right? And to have us all step into who we really are, who we really are.
Yeah.
And and they can through your help with your podcast, your classes that you're teaching, and just, you know, one-on-one client coaching. Work that you're that you're coaching. So
Wow, it's exciting.
Yeah. And you know, Uranus has moved up into your 10th house. Uranus is the planet of awakening. It's the rebel. And so, yeah, when we met and we knew you were leaving a job that you've been in for, you know, decades, that it was time for you to make this move. This is Uranus in the 10th house says you're going to be doing something different. And that's certainly what it is. And it's the ruler of your moon. So, you know, show people exactly who you are and the things you love and why you're brave and how you're real. And, you know, you're simply human, you know, as we all are.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes, indeed.
So I'm looking forward to coming to Portland because I'm going to be on your dinner list.
Yes, I can't wait.
Yes.
Yeah.
Without question.
Yeah.
So, and I, of course, will, for all of the listeners, include all of your social media handles in the description below. If anyone wants to, you know, check out his amazing podcast.
Subscribe, come on.
And, check out your, you got a website, right?
I do, yeah. Practical Soul. I haven't really launched the Be Real Human website because I'm focused more on the podcast.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
You know, part of what I'm doing right now is I'm still doing a lot of intuitive and executive coaching. So I take my intuitive skills, my work with Oracle cards that I've been learning with Colette for over 20 years, and bringing all that into kind of a very coaching format where people can look at the next right action for themselves. And so that's part of what I do in some of my day gig right now, but Practical Soul and lots of other places that with the podcast that Alex, you can share.
Okay, cool. And do they just get in contact with you via email? I can include that in the description too.
Absolutely. It's all right there on the website.
Wonderful.
Well, one of the cool things that I see in your chart with the Pluto at 22 degrees of an earth sign, that really this Saturn Pluto that's coming up at this 22 degrees in January, as you're part of the change, right? You're part of what you can being, you know, discard the past to pave the way for new success. So, you know, you're part of the change. There's a few people that are here to do that. You're one of them.
Thank you, Sandy.
Okay.
Thank you.
I see that. Yeah. We can't wait to, you know, keep in touch and be inspired by you and help support you and, you know, keep this journey going. Yeah. Until we're on to the next one.
Yes. All right. So it was great. Great talking to you tonight.
You guys too. Love you both.
Love you too. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Woo. Woo-hoo.
Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay. Good, Doug. Thank you.
That go okay?
Yes. That went great.
Yeah. What did you think?
It was great. I mean, I love doing this. It's easy for me, and especially when I'm doing with people like I love and appreciate. So yeah, I thought it was good. Yeah. A couple places I thought I talked a little much, but
no.
You're the guest.
Yeah, you're the one. Yeah, you're the star. We want to hear from you.
No, we just have major smiles over here, all of us.
Yeah, good.
Just curtain smiles. Okay, well, enjoy your IMAX theater. And look for a package in the mail. It went out yesterday.
Great, thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye. All right.
Okay, awesome. I know.
Love you both.
Okay.
Talk to you later.
All right.
Okay.
Bye bye.
Good night.